Hello guys, my name is Michael and I'm excited to be here because I'm going to be showing you how you can build your own custom-made radio for wireless connectivity. You can use the radio for transmitting, that is, if you're using it as an access point, an AP, or you can also use it as a station. And in both cases, it could either be used in a point-to-point scenario or a point-to-multipoint scenario. Okay, for you to do this, first of all, what you need to do is to have your own radio ordered. Okay, we have so many people that sell, so many companies dealing in enclosures like this. This one is from pointing straight off from South Africa. Okay, you order this first, and then you should also have this. You buy this router board. It is Microtik router board RB411. Okay, you can order it online. So many people who sell it. One of them is datacom express.com. okay, you can order this from them. And this one is a Microtik MMCX female bulkhead connector. Okay, and this one is a Microtik 350 milliwatts wireless card, 5 gigahertz. Okay, haven't got that. We are building a 5 gigahertz radio. If you're doing for 2.4, you get a 2.4 wireless card. So having said all that, this is called a 411 because it's going to be having one wireless card and one Ethernet port. Okay, so having done that, the first thing you want to do is to take this pigtail antenna and fix it here. See, like I'm doing right now. Done. It's very easy. And then you may want to know that this is actually, you check here to see that you're doing the right thing, because here is going to be the bottom of this enclosure. Okay, so that when you're plugging in your cable, it will be easier for you to plug in your Ethernet cable while this is facing upright. So having done that, you take this one, making sure that this port where the cable will be plugged to is facing downwards, and then you place it here where you want it to be. Okay, and then you screw. It's very simple, very easy to do. You tighten as well. Now, if you look at this other enclosure, you see this particular cable is for earthing, to make sure that you guide your radio, your antenna, because it's going to be up there, okay, either on the mast or on the water tank. So you have to make sure that, you know, the earthing is done properly. Okay, so this one will be connected to one of these ports here, one of the points that you can screw on the router board. So you just pick this one up, and then, you know, I just don't want to cover you guys so you can see what I'm doing. So we take this one using one of the nuts, and we just simply place it here and screw. Is that easy? See? So the last nut goes to this other point. Done. Very easy. This one, the Ethernet cable here from the Ethernet board, goes to the port I told you about. Just fix it, and then you take your wireless card and then slot it into this other space made for it. Why this one will go to the main, if you look closely at the wireless card, there are two small points that you can connect to there. One is main, one is auxiliary, so you connect it to the main. Okay, this one will go to the main. Very easy. Done. We are done here. We close this one. And then you take the nuts here and place them at the right spot. Screw. we have ourselves a custom built radio. So our cable will go straight into here, while this one will be on the mast or on the water tank, either transmitting or receiving, depending on how you configure it. Okay, to configure this radio, you need a PoE adapter, and then you have to run a cable from the PoE adapter to this place while the adapter is plugged to power. Okay, and then the other point on the adapter, the cable that will go to your laptop will be plugged to that place. So once you have that done, you can log into it using Winbus. Okay, and then you have your radio configured. Thank you guys for watching, and keep looking out for more videos on timigate.com.